What's wrong, Beckham Buckets? What's going on? Hi. Hi, I gotta get some Aziz light in here. Aziz light. Oh, it's okay. What? What's wrong? It's Super Bowl Sunday. You ready to see not your favorite team in the Super Bowl? And we gotta get your brother too. Look, it's Mama. Yeah. Mommy and Daddy been cleaning for hours, okay? Isn't that weird? Alright, time to get Brody. Hey, my man, what's going on, dude? Ready? Brody, light! Brody, light! That's bright, huh, bud? You ready? It's Super Bowl Sunday, dude. Do you know what that is? Super Bowl Sunday? Huh? Yeah. Mommy and Daddy been cleaning. We got Mansi. All right, let's go downstairs. Wait, what are you saying? Now you're talking? Get that kitty out of here, right? No? Okay. We clean. Your playroom's now back in the playroom, okay? So don't be surprised. Sorry, Daddy looks disgusting, but he's sweaty, constipated. Needs a shower, he's in his panties. Oh, look at both boys every day. This is how we do it. We show Mommy. Yeah. You smell like piss, and so do you. I think you need baths tonight, too. Let's go, Mommy. Let's go downstairs. Look at Daddy's blood, isn't it nice? And egg? Yuck.
You can go down first, and then you can record again.
When we come. We're coming down. Here we go. We're coming down. We're boys.
Hi, Papa.
Say hi, Mama.
Hi, Mama. Brody. Hi, Brody. Hi, Beckham.
Hi, Mama.
Hi.
All right, let's get you changed. We got a real job.
Can we go like this, Mommy? But oh, this is a different bottle, so you might be all pissy today. And we go. Like this, just over here with the airplane, we're like, remember how yesterday you went, Eero!
It's like, I don't want that bottle. You have to have this bottle. You do the switch.
So pissed.
Well, we'll figure it out.
What's good, Beckham? What's going on? Don't give me any of that crap. Put this down. You don't need it down. You don't want it, don't eat it. You need to be fed. No. Did you both laugh at the same time for once? Never. Could never make it happen. Where's your smiles at? Huh?
Alright, Mommy. Mommy's gotta go get in the shower and stuff. Or I gotta get in the shower. We gotta change it first.
Look at these diaper boys. I want my mama. Is that what you're trying to say? I want my mama? What? You didn't want to eat this bottle. You got to learn to use this bottle.
It's a sippy cup.
It's easy. All right, there we go. We got little brother and space dude. What is your problem? It's Super Bowl Sunday. We don't get to cry on Super Bowl Sunday. Yeah, dude, look, I completely cleaned up your toy room, put everything back in here. It's like Christmas, dude. Look at it, man, it's like everywhere. Isn't that awesome? Look at all this stuff. Huh? What are you going to play with first? Of course, you go right into the stuff I put away. What you got? What are you reaching in there for? What do you get?
The ball. Brody's favorite toy is the ball. He has plenty of balls.
Good job. That one doesn't fit, but it's good. He gets the idea.
But yeah, this is all clean. We'll see what it looks like later on tonight. It's going to be destroyed. All right. So while Rebecca's watching the kids, I need to get a shower, boo-boo. Ow. Fuck. It's in my face. I don't have my glasses on, so I can't really see what I'm doing.
Boo-boo. Creechy. Creechy. Out of breath because I'm fat.
Ah!
scaring your brother. You're scaring Beckham. You gotta be nice to Beckham. You gotta not scream so much. What's wrong, Beckham? What's wrong? You okay? Are you okay? You wanna do some crawling? Rolling, whatever you're doing? Okay, I'm sorry. Oh my goodness, what? What is that gonna prove? By hitting he just hit that seat for some reason. I don't know why. He lost one of his balls, went under the couch. That's what happens, bud. You keep it all in there, man. Hi, Beckham. Beckham. Beckham was just crying hysterically for some reason. He's trying to crawl again. You gonna crawl? You can do it. Come on. Crawl to daddy. Crawl to daddy, Beckham. He just started doing this last week, kicking his legs and his arms around. If you remember how Brody did it, he laid on his belly and just swam. Come on, Beckham. Crawl to dada. Beckham. All right, we'll check back with him later. There it is. He's trying. Oh my god, he was just crawling. He moved a little bit. Crawl to me, buddy. He moved his arms first and then his legs. Crawl to daddy. You can do it. Come on, Beckham. Crawl to me. Come on, you can do it. Yeah, good job. Crawl to dada. When I'm not looking and I'm not paying attention, that's when he tries to come to me. See if we can get it when I move away. If we don't pay attention to him, he'll start. Morgan Freeman. If you are one of us. What you doing? Huh? What you got? Balls? You got balls, huh? Triangle. I thought that was Beckham. It's boo-boo. But you'll see. I'll do a time lapse today at the end of this video. You'll see he'll be all over the place. He'll be like here. And he's all over. It's the first time he's had this much open space, though.
Show me your bounces. Bounce, Beckham, bounce. Bounce, Beckham, bounce. He's gotten so good at bounces. And he falls asleep in his chair all the time, as you saw. Bounce, Beckham, bounce. Bounce, Beckham, bounce. Yeah, good job. He's so handsome.
Why you all up in daddy's ball sack, man?
Daddy's a joke.
Yeah, you show your brother how to work that ish. Show him how to work it.
How's it work?
Look, Ed's here. I was gonna actually wear that cat liberation army shirt.
We're in Target and some lady walked by and I was just like, give me a
look. What are you doing, dude? What are you climbing all up on me for, huh?
Oh, Mr. Needy.
Show in April.
How are you?
April 28th.
I'll try to be there. What are you doing? And make you cry? It's okay, he's not gonna hurt you. It's okay. Oh my god. I just hold this breath. Breathe.
It's okay, I promise.
Oh my goodness. Brody if you cuddles. Pick him up, he'll be fine. You gotta hold him and stuff.
Brody cuddles and
you're okay. Cuddles. You're okay. I know. It's so weird because every baby's different. It's okay, buddy. We know. You're okay.
What's up, boy?
It's making my children cry. He's got one smile and the other one crying. Brody, what's going on, man? This boy needs a bath so bad, dude. We didn't get a chance to do it. So look at his hair.
Brody, you take a bath?
Welcome to my life, Ed.
Oh, my
Lord. Beckham, you're doing good, dude. See your brother? He loves him. Yeah, he's a little scared of people sometimes.
Yeah, I can see.
You okay? See, he's not going to do anything to you. Give him a kiss. I'm fine. Or if you're sick, actually, yeah. Are you sick?
No.
Kiss him on the cheek. He loves kisses. He's like, oh, I know that feeling. See, he's like, I know that feeling. See, he's not going to hurt you. He's not going to hurt you. It's like, you ain't my dad, motherfucker.
You just have scruff.
It's okay.
Jesus, kids are heavy.
What is wrong with you today, Mr. Awesome?
Here. Oh, he is so pissy today. I don't know what's going on with him. He is pissed.
Alright, the girls prepared some lovely food over here. It was Jess. It was all Jess.
I opened those.
Oh, Rebecca, you opened those? Good job, babe.
I put that stuff in the oven.
We're waiting for the pizzas.
Yes.
Let me see the pizzas. Oh, yeah. This is the cooking I'm used to by mommy. But she did cook a crock pot. She's got something going in the crock pot, so. Yeah. Nice job, ladies. You did good. I like how you're like, I opened these. I opened these.
Okay.
How's your breath smell? Can you get the smell of the breath?
Should be good.
You eating the pepperonis yet?
Ow, you're choking me. I have breath.
Does he like it?
Mm-hmm.
It's good, huh? All of you, mostly. Look, it's the lizard man, the reptilian George Bush himself.
Please let him flip the coin.
He's a reptilian! Flip the coin in the hole. Oh god, this is awful. It's pretty funny though. I know I shouldn't be laughing at this, but I really don't care.
Yeah, I don't like the bushes.
I'm not a fan of the bushes either. Reptilians everywhere!
I don't like bushes to people or bushes on vaginas.
What? Oh. You don't like bushes on vaginas either?
Ed's being a little pervert. Say, I like bushes on vaginas. Yeah.
Hi, blue-eyed beauty. Let's get those baby blues on video. Let's get up close. We got the light on. We can see them good. Get one of them at least. Probably gonna be creepy looking. Oh, he's all over the place. He's ready for bed. It's Mr. Fussy Pants. Hey, let me see your baby blues. Hey. Up here, little man. Let me see those baby blues. Yeah, baby blues. You were talking all week, huh? Yeah, he's handsome boy. Handsome. But he's whining and crying. What is this fake crap? You do the fake crap now too, huh? All right. Ed was just saying how much Brody loves football because he does. He's like obsessed with it, dude. Every time we put it on, he just stares at it. He doesn't even do this with his cartoons anymore. Nah, he's more into the sport.
Now he's already even quiet. He's put on a replay of an old game.
Yeah, like, I know, right? Does it with wrestling, too.
Yeah.
You're starting again, huh? What you gonna do, Mommy? You wanna take over? Let's get it. Oh my goodness. That's a big one. Yeah, I know, right? Are we getting your face? I can't tell. Doing the farts? That's a big one. That's one of your biggest ones yet. Yeah. You ready for bed? No, of course not. Why would you be? Let's continue this. Let's see if we can get him some more. Oh, Such a little fat kid. Why are you so fat? Oh, I'm getting right in a humidifier. Oops, that wasn't good. He's breaking his camera. Way to go. That wasn't smoke. That was air. What the air? Burr, burr. Oh, burr, burr, burr. Alright, now your brother wants attention.
Are you done? Huh? I need to change you too. Come on.
Another one? Redemption. Wow. Yes. No, we don't eat it. This is for on your ass, okay? We don't eat this. This goes on your ass, okay? You don't eat it.
Like when he retires.
What's good, man? Hey, can I get in there like I did with your brother here? Come on. Come on, like we used to do when you was baby. Come on. Get over it. No, you don't need that thing, man. I want love. I want love. I want love. Give me all my love. Give me my love. Give me my love. Come here.
Alright, play with it all you want.
Yeah! I've never seen a kid so excited about Destin. Aquaphor. Goes on your butt. Yeah! He's over here like, yeah!
Yeah!
Yeah! Yeah!
Yeah! Yeah!
Yeah!
Touchdown!
I'm glad I'm enjoying the game.
Oh no!
Hey, my man, what's good? Hey, are you good? Are you good? Hi, you ready for bed or what? Beckham, when he tries to hit this, he throws hands. He starts swinging really hard. We'll see if we get him on video doing it. Go, Beckham, go, throw hands. He's crazy today. Throw them hands. Show us how you throw hands. Come on. Throw the hands. That was gentle. He'll go like, poof, 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 poof. That's sweet. Throw hands. So goofy today. Give me back my hands. Give me back my hands. Got little, your hands are on daddy's, huh? Little hands. Little hands. Where's little hands? Where's little hands? Where's little hands? Yeah. Alright, buddy, as we work on getting that halftime show. Yeah, you see yourself? I never show you, huh? Because we don't ever put you in your bed. You just started doing this. Ready to go to bed? Yeah. It's about to be halftime. And you're getting grumpy. Look, it's Captain Creature. Hey, Creechy, what's up, Creechy? Joel? Okay, buddy, sweet dreams. Love you. Get some sleep, okay? No, no, no goof time. Sleepy time. Love you. Well, it's blurry. There we go. Alright, you're going to bed too. He's a little fussy. He's tired. There's Creature. Same routine. Let's go. Are you ready? Let's go. Oh, you hear your brother in there? He's whining. Let's go. Bedtime. Good night, handsome. Love you. Tomorrow is bath time for both you two. You're overdue. Get some sleep, okay? Love you. Very much. Dickle? Dickle? Bye, buddy. Love you. Let's do this crap. What do you want, Monty? What? Yeah. What? What do you fucking want? You got two kids to take care of. Only five other kids to take care of. You're crazy. Keys are ow! Hey! What are you doing to my hand? If I want to get out of here. She's so crazy, dude. Look at her vomit. I showed you guys already, but look, there it is again. What? What? She wants to play all the time. Jump, get it. Monty, get it. Get it, Monty. Get it, Monty. She's the only one that jumps and does wild things. Jump. Get it, Monty. Get it. she had calls. This was like the most painful thing I ever endured.
Boo boo! Boo boo! Lights out.
Blanket and Django. Lazy as all fucking hell.
Blanket just doesn't ever leave the bed all day.
Alright, so as we're about to go into the half, 21-0 Atlanta. Morristown, New Jersey.
You have a chance.
Eating with your hands, boy. Like a man. Alright, the children are in bed. We're enjoying the second half. Nothing crazy. Just enjoying the kids being in bed. Helmets stuck together. Helmets stuck together. Like, what in the fuck? That's gonna be all over the internet tomorrow. Oh my god. I'm fucking dead, dude. Like, literally just went to kick the extra point. Patriots are not playing very well today. All the games. Alright, so now it is 28-20. Falcons. But, I mean, it was 28-3. And now it's 28-20. As they just scored a touchdown and a two-point conversion. Anytime it comes to the Patriots or the Cowboys, personally, I can't stand watching. My root for them to lose always. You know, I really hope the Falcons pulled off tonight. Like, they're ahead still 28-20, but now we have a football game. That's it's 28-20, as you can see here. And I'm just getting a little worried here. So I ran outside to have a cigarette. That is a catch. Holy shit. Wow. There's another look. Look at it. Never hits the ground. It's definitely a catch. Because look, right there. It's clear as day that it's a catch.
That's insane.
Patriots score. Now they need that two-point conversion. This is it. A two-point conversion.
Off the fucking sneak.
Oh my god! He was over! They fucking tied it! He was over!
He was offside. He was offside.
Offside on Atlanta. Oh my god, I think the Patriots. It's a tie game. Oh my god, the Super Bowl is going into overtime. Fuck!
Bombs it down.
Oh my god, is it picked off? Oh my god, they're running with it. What the fuck? There he goes, out of bounds. We're going into the first time ever in Super Bowl history.
That's what you fucking get.
Oh my god, you gotta be kidding me! Oh, he dropped it.
Are you kidding me? You're gonna throw a flag on that?
Well, at least Boo Boo, you're all comfy and stuff, yeah. But it looks like
looks like the Patriots are going to win here in overtime because they won the flip of the coin. And if they score a touchdown in overtime, since they won the coin toss, they win, which is kind of bullshit. I think it needs to go back and forth. I mean, this is how I feel. But they're on the one, and it looks like they're going to score first down. I don't know. You got to be kidding me. Falcons almost intercepted it.
You're so cute, Boo Boo. Black Cat Lives Matter, we know. Yeah. He's a little girl. He's a pain in the ass.
You guys see this. Second and goal here. Oh my god, he's gonna run it in. No. No. Oh!
No. No!
Oh my. Patriots win the Super Bowl again. Fifth. Fucking. Ah! He's so good, it hurts. Crowd is in silence. I know, Jang.
The Falcons coach literally cost us this game. To make sure.
James White driving.
They've already shut off the confetti. Fans are yeah, that would field. Suck if you were here to play and it wasn't a touchdown there. Maybe you shouldn't have jumped the gun
actually,
there.
Actually, I don't know. His knee was down. It does to me
too, Joe. I am sorry, Falcons fans. If I were you right now, I'd be really upset. Because you guys were destroying in the beginning. All right, everybody.
that is going to conclude another TJ and Friends vlog. I apologize ahead of time, of course, that I have not been vlogging as much as I want to, but it's a little difficult when you have, you know, the two little boys that I have, and Rebecca's working all the time. So it's a lot of time it's just me taking care of the kids, and it's something we agree on, you know, like, if she's going to work all the time, she has to drive through city traffic, go to work from God knows how long. She'll be leaving here at like 6:30 in the morning sometimes and doesn't come back till, you know, when the kids are about to go to bed or if they're not already in bed. And besides all that, Super Bowl 51 was awesome. I enjoyed it. You know, good for you, Tom Brady. As many people are going to bash and hate on you, you know, but you did it. You can tell he did it with a lot of love, man. As you saw, like, his mother suffering, I believe she might have cancer, I don't know. I don't really keep up on people's personal lives, you know. I try to stick with my own life, close friends. But it seems like he's going through a lot, and, you know, for him to come back from the score you saw tonight, it was pretty unbelievable. Not saying it was fair in the overtime, but, you know, it happened. But it was quite beautiful that he actually pulled it off, and, if you're a Patriot fan, I'm sure you're marking out, or Tom Brady fan. I'm not going to lie, I'm a Tom Brady fan. Like, he's talented, man. How can you hate the man? He's very talented. Whew. I know today's vlog was mostly just me and the kids, and sorry, I'm like looking at myself in the camera. My big head. I started my day off with my green juice. I didn't vlog all that. You know, you see me do my green juice. It's been almost like 3 months since I've done it, and I haven't been feeling too well. And I decided to do it today, and I've never felt better. And I need to just, like, stay on all the time. It's very confusing for me at times to stay on that stuff because it thickens my blood, and that can be difficult for my heart at times, but it's also good for it with all those antioxidants and all that stuff. God, why do I look so crap? Ugh. I can't balance this hat out. Fat fuck. I'm losing my hair. It sucks. God, getting old is awful. 35. Look at that hairline now. But, my thing is, like, with my kids, I know it's a lot of me just kissing my kids and loving them. That's it, man. When they're this young, you know, throughout their life period, you should show them as much love as possible, because that's how human beings turn out to be good human beings, from what I can think or experience. I mean, when I was a child, I had plenty of love for my parents, like, growing up. It was awesome. And of course, the years as went on, you know, you get older, and it's not always there, you know. I didn't never witnessed my parents kissing on video out of all the videos. Isn't that crazy? Like, there's not one video of my parents ever interacting with each other emotionally, like, loving each other. And I think that's very important to having a relationship, especially for kids, too. I want them to see that they're very loved. I'm like, I have any videos of my mom or my dad kissing me? I don't know. That's pretty crazy, right? I mean, it was different times. We didn't have little tiny cameras in our pockets all the time, but alright, but as today is, I'm going to end this vlog. I'm sure I'm going to talk for like 10 minutes. You know, not drinking like I used to, so. This is me sober. Having cigarettes, though, still. But, reading a lot on what's going on today, and I took down a lot of notes. These aren't my words, but, you know, it's organized words from many others, and, you know, like, we all struggle every day. We all suffer on the inside every day. We worry, we procrastinate, we feel overwhelmed, we feel angry, we feel lonely, we don't feel good enough, we wish we were thinner. I wish I was thinner all the time, but you know, sometimes I don't care what I look like, but for my health, yeah. We wish we had more money, we wish our jobs were different, we wish our relationships were different sometimes. We think everything in life should be easier, and yet every one of these struggles is self-created. And I love that, because it is. It's all, we all self-create this in our heads. And, but they are real. But they're only real because we've created them in our heads. We've attached ourselves to certain ideals and fantasies about how life has to be in order to be good enough for us. We worry because things might not turn out how we expect. We procrastinate because we fear discomfort and failure. We feel overwhelmed because we think we should be further along than we are. We feel angry because life should not be this way. And it goes on. But it's like all in your head. And it doesn't have to be that way. I mean, at least not for you if you make it that way. And I try to learn and live by these words. I mean, this is coming from many people, and I've tried to organize some words. I'm not the best writer or anything. I am not good at writing or putting things together, but I take down notes of people that have had some good peace of mind, and I like to organize these thoughts. And there's something else. You can think better, you can live, or excuse me, you can think better, you can live better. This is a choice you can make. Take a deep breath and let all that thinking, go. Just bring your attention to the present moment. Focus on what's here with you now. The light, the sounds, your body, the ground under your feet, the objects and people moving and resting around you. Don't judge these things against what they should be. Just accept what they actually are. Because once you accept reality, you can improve it. See life as it is. Without all the ideals and fantasies you've preoccupied with, let go all of the stressful distractions and just experience this moment. This moment is good enough as it is. And I try to like live by those words in a way. Try to, but I'm not always successful about it. I have plenty more notes. I'm just going to read along. You know, why not? Let's see where. There is a lot about our lives we absolutely cannot control. Our expectations often make us utterly unhappy. We will always be incredibly imperfect. A moment spent worrying is a moment wasted. The best lessons often come from the hardest days. Very true, in my personal experience. Success easily gets to our heads, and failure easily gets to our hearts. We confuse being busy with being productive. Now, this is something that I completely agree on. That is insanity. That you think being busy is being productive, it's not. I mean, I get it. We all have to go to our 9-to-5s, and it sucks. I mean, I fortunately do not have to do that, but my kids are a 9-to-5. I mean, they're actually more than a 9-to-5. They're basically... Depends on what time they get up at. There are 7 until 7 at night. And I do nap in the afternoon, but, you know, as of lately, I have not been napping. So it never ends. But I love these boys very much. As you see, I show them plenty of love. And it's not because I'm doing it for the camera. I do this off camera, too. I love my kids. It comes easy. Just kiss them and love them and make them laugh. Nothing better than a child's laughter. More money left unmanaged just creates more problems. Most of us don't need more to be happy. We need less. Yes, I agree on that. I don't know. I'm not even going to get into that. Our fancy gadgets often get in our way and dehumanize us. And this is completely true. And Rebecca and I even do it sometimes. You'll see in a time lapse probably today. We're probably both on our multimedia devices. She's a little worse than I am. I mean, she knows that, you know. But, you know, it kills time, and, you know, we need to get off them as much as possible. Get off social media. I did not go on Facebook, and I didn't even go on the iPad at all today. You know, I don't have a phone. So I did not go on there at all. I didn't see what's going on. I'll do it tomorrow when I have some free time. My kids are sleeping, and I'll do it then. But it definitely dehumanizes you. When I was younger, I mean, relationships were so much tighter. Like, nobody, like, really, we didn't have that. So, I mean, we always had to just interact with each other. Now today, everybody's like, let's go on my iPad or my iPhone or your Android, whatever, just going on social media and constantly, like, seeing what other people are up to. Don't worry about what's going on. Just like we said, like, five, six steps ago, like, just focus on what's going on now. As a society, we are utterly infatuated with our outer beauty. Me, I mean, when I was younger, I was, but I get it. People today can be. When single life, especially, you want to look as good as possible. You want to attract the opposite sex or same sex, whatever. You want to be with somebody that loves you, but you don't have to do that all the time. Most of our arguments we have with one another are pointless. That I completely agree on. My parents witnessed that plenty of times. And me and Rebecca have arguments. We definitely know they're pointless. It's stupid. We apologize all the time. We default to judging others by their actions and ourselves by our ideals. We don't always get what we give. None of us know anyone worth continually blaming. Unfortunately today, a lot of people do, and you can't continue to do that. It's easier to hold on to the way things are than it is to go and grow. That's right, it is, it's hard. But you have to, you know, let that stuff go, man. If we want the benefits of something in life, we have to also want the cost. Even with all our advancements, progress, and still require old-fashioned work, we never feel 100% ready when good opportunities arise. And I completely agree on that. I mean, I've had opportunities in my life, and I never feel 100% satisfied. Like this channel, I've had plenty of people contact me throughout the years. And there's a company now I'm kind of hesitant to sign with. I don't know. But they only have 10 people with their company. The company I'm signed with now, there's like literally, it started out small, but now there's literally tens of thousands, and they don't do anything for me. And I need to move on and find somebody that's utterly interested in me. But at the same time, it's hard to continually do vlogs all the time. But this company's actually offering a deal where I can film, send the footage to them. They'll edit the footage of me. You know, it's a 70-30 deal. But, I mean, it might do big things for me. So, I mean, it might be something I should do because filming comes easy to me. And I can make it very interesting. It's the editing. When I go back to editing, it's very difficult for me when it comes to time. Because by the time my kids go to bed and I've been up for like 12 hours, I'm ready for bed. And I don't have time for all that. At least not now. I can't. Like, it's really hard. I edited the other day with the kids and they let me do it. Beckham is getting so good. Like, as he grows, it's getting a lot easier for me. And I'm really looking forward to him being bigger with his brother. It's going to be awesome. Many of us will have our lives cut short. One way or another, none of us live forever, as it's much harder to change the length of your life than it is to change the depth of it. So how deep will you go today? That's something you should reflect on, definitely. Because how we spend our days is how we spend our lives. And I'm going to say something now. I go to a lot of these independent wrestling shows. There's a man that goes to these shows, a man by the name of Kevin Hogan. He was a biggest wrestling fan ever, and he's a definition of how wrestling fans should be. Out of like the, let's see here, 2-hour drive, he's been to like every independent wrestling show in the circuit, and I wish I had spoke more with him. I only spoke with him twice. I remember going to ECW shows when I was younger as a kid, and he was there. And unfortunately, he passed away in a car accident this week, in a head-on collision with a track and trailer. I mean, I don't know details of what went on, but the fact of the matter is he passed away. And from what I can see from, like, having a lot of wrestling fans on my social media, that he was very loved and very welcome and a very kind man. And I got that vibe just from meeting him twice. He was known as the Muffin King, and he would bring muffins to the shows. You might see him a couple times. He'd bring a rubber chicken to the ring, and his life was cut short, like, extremely short. Like, life is fucking crazy, man. And rest easy, Hogan. You know, you're very loved and very welcome. Every show I'm going to around here, they're all doing 10 bell salutes for you and all that stuff. And wherever you are, I hope they got some kind of wrestling going on there. I'm sure they do. Of all the people we've lost in CZW Independent Circus, I'm sure you guys got something going on up there, man. Rest easy, brother. And as America today, as our trying times, like, it's crazy to think of all this shit we're going through right now. But we never agree on anything. And the simple thing we should all just agree on, everybody's out there throwing fists at each other, doing things that are just unbelievable. Okay, you have the right to protest and more power to you. But when violence comes in mind, like, you shouldn't be being violent towards people. Like, I've seen the most craziest things, and I'm sure a lot of you know. I mean, it's insane. Don't be violent towards other people. You know, we're all going to agree on one thing, that we're all Americans. And, I mean, there's going to be these people that are going to have their craziness, and we'll separate ourselves from them. Don't just lash out on people because you see one example of somebody and you think they're just like them. They're not, you know. You only need to sit down and think about what you really all can agree on. And the fact of the matter is that we're Americans. We want our freedom and we want to be safe. And I think that's what we all will agree on. And I know we're all going to have these differences, and it sucks. But the more you lash on people and cause violence and hate, and you're just fueling that hate with more hate, you can't do that. I feel like I've been talking way too much. It's like 15 minutes. So if you're still watching, so I hope you enjoyed the video today, my kids. That's it. These videos are for them. These videos are for my kids. And of course for me and Rebecca Cruz in the future, family. Anyone wants to see my sister, we see our kids, you know, see my kids grow, man. I love it. And I'm gonna end it here, guys. Stop judging, start loving, accept others for who they are, and just be yourself, man. Take care. Because America needs it right now. With love. Alright, so I forgot to mention actually that you know, a lot of you watch my channel and you see the stuff of my dad. I only put one video up this last week of my dad. Like I promised, I'm going to put them all up. But it was something I wanted to like talk about, and I just didn't get into it because I was getting into my motivational speeching notes. By the way, they weren't my notes. I mean, well, they were my notes, but like from many other people. February 1st is a very difficult day for me to go through, and now that it's been 10 years since my father passed away, it's even more difficult. And like I said in some of the comments there, like, you know, you get over all that stuff, but once you have children and you don't have anything to fall back on, like me and Rebecca had a good conversation yesterday. I don't have anywhere to go with my kids besides, like, you know, my mom's relatives, my dad's. It's not really, you know, we have my dad's side too. I can if I push it, but I'm not going to. But I just want a home to go to, like, where I can bring my parents' grandkids to. Like, I would love to just show up where my mom and dad, imagine my mom and dad still together today, and just like show up like, hey, I got Brody and Beckham here. But I don't have that. It's very hurtful. It is. It's very hurtful. And I know I'm not alone on this, and it sucks. You know, I would love that. Like, we're just like, all right, Rebecca, what do you want to do? Like, this weekend, let's bring the kids over to Grandma and Grandpa's house. And even, you know, even on her side, like, you know, her parents split up when she was, like, a teenager. Like, around the same time my parents split up, actually. It's the one thing we do have in common. Like, we have our little things in common, but when it comes to family, we have that in common. And, obviously, both of us can agree, it's very hurtful. I do not want my kids to ever experience that. And, all the differences Rebecca and I ever had, and I respect her so much. Like, you know, as difficult as I can be for her, as difficult she can be from, as difficult as I can be for her, or she can be for me, you know, vice versa, whatever. We make it work, and you have to at least try to. And her and I were talking, like, we feel stuck at times. We don't have any opportunities today. You know, the land of the free, home of the brave, America. There's no difference today between, and I get into it, like, politically with her. There's no difference between, well, there is a difference, but there's plenty of difference. There's no, like, middle class today. It's just lower class and upper class. Either you have a lot of money or you don't have a lot of money. And I'm not the only one. And, I mean, I see plenty of friends that even went to school for things today. And, did their 4 or 6 years of college, and I mean, if 4 years, okay, but then if you didn't go to grad school and do other things, you probably ain't going to nail a nice job today, you know? And even when you do nail a nice job, you're still making, like, what, like, 40 grand a year? That's not going to cut it to have a family today. Like, it's not. And in the state of New Jersey, we're paying, like, $6,500 in taxes, and then the bills keep piling up. You know, you got your, as we do here, we have our taxes, and then we have our landscaping fee, sewer bill, water bill, electricity bill, and our home isn't actually very heated. It's heated well, but I mean, then we have to run the heat constantly. So, like, we get our utility bills are sometimes $400 a month. Now, tell me how, when you have a $400 utility bill on top of your $100, $150 water sewage bill, $6,500 or like $400, $500 in taxes, your mortgage fee. It's just not easy to get by today, and it shouldn't be like that for people. Human beings are not meant to live this way. We're not meant to, like, just get by. It's not fair. It's not. It's really not fair at all. I know when my parents were growing up, it started to get difficult for them, but their parents had it easy, and I saw from experience with my grandparents, like, they had, like, the American dream. Like, things were balanced a lot more in the 50s and 60s. It's not like that today. As we push on to 2020, shit is getting a lot more fucked up. as much as we like, you see Rebecca and I, obviously, as I make these vlogs, anytime I go out and do something, we make a vlog. We don't get to do anything. And that's fine right now with our kids, but even as they get bigger, I feel like it's going to be more difficult for us to go out and spend money to do something. Maybe we'll go to the aquarium or something, but like it shouldn't be like that. We should be able to take a family vacation, do this, do that, and it just is not happening today. That wasn't what I wanted to talk about, but you get the idea. And, you know, many of you guys suffer today, and it sucks. Like, I don't understand why we have to live this life today. Systematic bullshit, man. Somebody's hoarding all the money away. It's not working out for America. And, you know, as much as you hate Trump, I hate him too sometimes. Like, I see what he's doing with the pipeline, other shit. And, I mean, he's a businessman. I hope he does good things. You gotta, like, try to give him a chance. Because a lot of the shit that people say about him today, it's the same thing that Obama was doing, but he ain't publicizing it. It's just madness. I don't know. It's madness. But don't let that fuel hate on your side and hate other people. You got, like I just said earlier, understand we all want our freedom. We want things to work out. We're all American. And we want the best. But, damn it, 6 minutes. What the fuck? How does it go so quick? But yeah, I've been editing videos of my dad. It's been 10 years now. And it's been a really shitty thing for me to go through as being a father now, knowing that I'm not going to have my kids ever meet my father, obviously. Hopefully they will meet their grandmother someday. My mom will figure that out. And I'm going through a lot of stuff now myself. If you read some of my comments before of some things, you know, I'm going through some crap that I'm going to lose my license. I'm sure you can figure that out. I don't want to talk about it because it's a bad reminder of me. But, yeah, as I go through these videos of him, there's a lot of regrets. I don't have videos of me just, like, sitting in bed with him and hanging out with him before he went and going to see him before he passed away. And I just have stuff of him, like, literally, like, passing away and his viewing and just all that stuff. It hits me. It's hard to, like, go through. So a lot of these videos will not be edited. Just be straight raw footage. I don't want to see my dad, like, later on videos of him angry, and he is angry in some of these, like the one I just posted of him, like having a phone call of him going through like a conversation of not wanting to sell drugs to his friend, because that's what my dad had to do. You know, my parents split up, he had a fluctuating mortgage, and he had to do what he had to do to get by, and I had just gotten over having fucking heart failure, all this crap, and he was relying on me for payments that we had many people rent from us, and my dad was getting disability his whole life. $900 a month ain't gonna do shit. I tried to convince him many times, sell the place, just go live out in Florida, figure it out, man. Just don't stay here in this house. I'm saving this house for you. And I wanted the house, and I'm not gonna get it, because once my parents split up, the mortgage had like about, it was down to $10,000. It had maybe 3 or 4 years left on it, if that was paid off, and then it all fell apart. He's like, I'm saving it for you, all the time reminding me. But I knew it wasn't reality, and I tried to tune in with reality. It didn't work. But yeah, as I watch these videos of him, it's like literally him going to hospice, coming back from hospice, and you know, losing somebody, period. Like, I mean, it's always hurtful. I know my dad was thankful for the life he had. Very laid-back man. And like I told you before, like I wanted to go see him at hospice before he passed away. His brother called me and told me to come in. Your dad's about to pass away. Do you want to come in? I told him, I can't do it, man. I couldn't do it. I wanted to remember how he was, but I already had images of him. Like, I was there the last time, and T carried me to the bathroom. I carried him to the bathroom. He was in a fucking diaper, fell, hit his head on the fucking sink, carrying him over half naked, his diaper half unstrapped, and, like, watching my father, like, pee, piss and shit himself, and, like, it was just something I didn't want to remember, and it still stuck in my head, so I never went and showed up. I never sat there and laid on the bed with him and just had a joint with him and did some things I wanted to do, and I just never had the balls to do it because we weren't that tight. Like, and I want my kids, like, if I ever went through that situation, I want my kids to be as tight as possible with me. So if your kids ever see this, like, daddy's ever going through that, just come up to daddy, you know, do whatever daddy wants to do. Let's sit there and watch some home videos of us together and just enjoy each other's company, man. I think all families should be as tight as possible. And I'm just ranting on. again, I'm going to definitely end this now. It's easier when you're sober.
Yeah, it's coming on 12 o'clock. I gotta go to bed, man. Kids will be up at 7. But again, guys, stop judging, start loving, accept those who are, and just be yourself. Meow. I love you. Take care.